because I've never read anything about this in our Shastras. What does Indian ancient culture and heritage about the family? What are you saying about the family? So that I want to know from you, if you can guide us this one.
No, see, family, see, essentially, the family is called a grahastha ashrama.
Okay.
Right? And if you look at ashram, the word ashram.
Okay.
Shram, jahan shram nahi hai, wahi ashram hai.
Oh, wow.
Okay.
I have never heard this definition before.
Right? So, we have four stages in life. One is called...
Guruji, sorry, one question. Jaha shram nahi hai means there is no effort.
There's no stress.
Okay. So, but shram is parishram. We say parishram. What is parishram then? Parishram,
no, parishram is effort. Okay.
Okay.
It also can be in stress. I'm speaking of Sanskrit. I don't know Hindi colloquial usage.
No. Sanskrit. You tell about Sanskrit only.
Yeah. Yeah. Shram. Jaha shram nahi hai, wahi ashram hai. Right? So, our ancestors divided the four stages of life into four stages.
Okay.
What is called Brahmacharya Ashram,
Grahastha
Ashram, Vanaprastha Ashram,
and
Sannyasa Ashram. Okay?
Right.
So now, if you look at all the four places, the ashram word is common.
Correct.
So what it means is that all the four stages of life has to be stress-free.
Okay.
See, that is the purpose of this ashram concept. Okay. They said, you are living in four stages of life. All the four stages you should make stress-free.
Okay.
Now, take the education system, right?
Right.
How education system can be stress-free? Okay. Education system is very stressful today because you are encouraging a lot of competition. Okay, every day you are putting the bottom guy to top guy. You are encouraging too much of competition.
And discrimination also.
And discrimination. Okay. Education system is not tuned for your aptitude, but it's a mass production system. Okay, so it's a donkey or monkey. Or a horse, all of them have to learn running. That's the education system today.
Correct.
So this creates a lot of stress.
Right.
So in ancient days, the education system was not like that.
Right.
Ancient day, the guru used to identify the talent in each person.
Okay.
Okay, and he used to train him in that talent.
He used to
give importance to the growing the talent in that person.
Okay.
So it's not a mass education system, but individual education system.
Right.
Okay. So right now in the current education system, we are trying to make fish climb
a trigger.
And if it doesn't climb, we will say that he's a useless guy. Okay. So this creates a lot of stress in the individual.
Right.
So can we have an education system where each person each person has an individual education system? I don't know, but that is the stress. In earlier days, it was not stress. It is a joy.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? So then, second, this one, as far as the education is concerned. Second aspect of education that was, education is called Brahmacharya Ashrama. So that means, the education is about Brahman, means reality.
Acharan in the Brahman.
Brahmacharya. Brahmacharya means living in what you call it, living in reality.
Living in
reality. Okay.
Means Brahmamech Acharan Karna.
Brahmani Charitam Manasam. Brahmacharya.
Okay.
So it is nothing to do with the unmarried life. In the colloquial Hindi, Brahmacharya means not married. It is not like that. Okay, so you have to learn to live in what you call as reality. Okay, so what do you mean by living in reality is not in the past, not in the future, totally in the present moment. okay? So the past,
that is Brahman.
Present moment is reality.
Okay.
See, now you are talking to me, right? So this is reality, the present moment reality.
Okay.
But if your mind is already jumping, okay? Oh, what is this Prabhu talking? He is talking nonsense. You are either you are going to past or you are projecting something on me. You are not listening. So totally live in the present moment is called Brahmacharya.
Okay.
And if you live in total present moment, okay, your life will be harmonious. And in that, the boy will be in a total peace. That's called Brahmacharya Ashrama. No stress at all.
Right.
So, two things. It's not about competition. It's about growing the individual talent. Third thing is living in a reality, higher reality called Brahmacharya.
Okay.
Okay. So, these things made the life of a boy peaceful.
Acharan means to think about Brahman or...
So, this is actually a wrong understanding.
Okay.
So, basically, Brahmacharya means, Brahman means reality.
Okay.
Charya means living.
Charya means living.
So, you are not thinking. The thinking means there is a gap.
Oh, okay.
See, it is like okay. There's a gap. So those who have translated that, they don't understand what is reality of that.
Okay.
Okay. So Brahmani Charitam Manasam, the mind is in Brahman, means in the total reality. So now. Then this is you understand now why it's called ashram, right?
Right. No stress.
It is actually peaceful.
Very peaceful, yeah.
And if there is a peaceful, the person will bloom. They will produce giants. That's how our country was able to produce many rishis who are very, very highly evolved.
Right.
So you have to focus on the individual talent and give attention to that. Not make a fish climb a tree.
Climb a tree and judge it. Yeah.
So then comes the Vanaprastha Ashram. Grahastha Ashram. Grahastha Ashram is called Ashram because there is no stress again. Why there is no stress? Because the husband and wife, okay, they are marrying for fulfillment of their desires, what is called Kama. So now, kama means desire.
Right.
So husband has certain desire, wife has certain desire. Both are trying to fulfill the desire by marrying. The desire can be security, the desire can be sex, the desire can be children, whatever is that.
Right.
So now, this desire, the nature of desire is it cannot be fulfilled anytime. It will be always growing. Right? It keeps on growing. The desire will never end. Today you are a Maruti car, tomorrow it's a BMW, now day after tomorrow it's a chartered plane.
Right.
So it'll keep on growing. And for the desire they need money, artha. For kama they need artha, money.
Correct.
Okay, the money, what is there, is a ka. Hello? For artha they need kama. For kama they need artha, money. Okay, for that they have to do earning.
Right.
So if you are doing a right way of earning and right way of living, okay, your mind will become peaceful one way. But that is not the end of it. Kama and artha has to be aligned with dharma. So dharma is a higher purpose in life.
Okay,
if there is a higher purpose in life, what will happen? There will be no stress.
Right.
For example, okay. So in India, the freedom struggle was there. In the freedom struggle, everybody's focus is freedom for India.
Correct.
Then people were ready to sacrifice their lives.
Right.
Okay, they are working together. They are working together.
Yes.
Okay, but the moment we got freedom, okay, so then the fight started for political power. Hello?
Yeah, hello. Then Prabhuji, the moment we got freedom?
The people started fighting.
Right.
The greed started, the jealousy started, the fight started.
Right.
So the higher purpose is gone. Now only selfishness. So, if husband and wife are able to live a life for higher purpose, then there is no selfishness and fight between them.
Correct.
So, then there is a peace in the house. That's why it's called grahastha.
Okay.
So, one who is established in dharma, husband and wife, it is called grahastha.
Okay.
If you are focusing on not selfishness, Me, for me and mine, but a higher purpose to serve the society, to perform the 5 yadnas, okay? The 5 yadnas, what we call as pancha yadna, right? Deva yadna, bhuta yadna, pitra yadna, rushi yadna, manushi yadna.
Right.
So these 5 yadnas, if they perform, they are actually, whatever they earn, a small portion of that goes to yadna. Then the life will be beautiful. Grahastha ashrama will be ashrama. Stress-free.
Right.
And they also undertake to produce children.
Right.
Not a child should be the desired child who is good, who is intelligent, and who will bring lot of good to the society.
Correct.
So like that, when they live your life, you live your life not for selfishness, but for what you call as service to the society, service to the God. Clear?
Yes. Yes.
Then your life will be grahastha ashrama. Then you are living a life of dharma.
Okay.
In brahmachari ashrama, you learned how to live in the reality.
Okay.
In the grahastha ashrama, how to live in the dharma.
So that practice has already happened for 12 years.
Yes.
25 years. How many?
Yeah, whatever. Alright? So now you are living in dharma. You are, whatever you have learnt, you are trying to contribute to the society, do service to the society, do service to the God.
Right.
There is no selfishness at all. Where there is no selfishness, there is no stress.
Correct.
Any amount of difficulty which comes in life, you will be able to face.
Right.
Okay, then you move into vanaprastha ashrama. Vanaprastha means going into the forest, which in literally it means you are moving away from city life, you are moving from your day-to-day interactions with the society. Okay, now you are able to focus on your own self.
Okay.
So there the focus is on more on meditation. So this meditation is called, this meditation practice is called upasana. Okay, whereas grahastha ashrama is focused on karma kanda, means rituals and karma yoga.
Right.
Okay, do karma yoga, make a living by earning money. Okay.
Right.
And do yadna, do live in an attitude of service, then the house will be full of peace.
Okay.
So then you come to stage or vanaprastha, where you are now, your social responsibilities are less.
Correct.
You are in retired life. Here you should focus on more of vanaprastha or meditation. Okay, meditation, higher reality, God, or supreme reality, self.
Okay.
So this is called vanaprastha ashrama. Here what they do, they will do to the society in terms of teaching.
Okay.
Or in terms of whatever they can go do, little bit service they do. Because there is no earning now.
Right. Right.
So then gradually they move into sannyasa ashrama. Sannyasa ashrama means now a life completely dedicated to self.
Okay.
So now you are establishing yourself in the Brahman. You are merging yourself in the Brahman.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So this is the state of ashram. Now, we should not confuse this with the stages of life.
Okay.
In a way, it is connected to the stages of life. A person can move from brahmacharya to grahastha to vanaprastha to sannyasa ashrama as a stages of life. But a person may move very rapidly in various stages without going through stages of life. It's a mental evolution,
not a
time-wise evolution. So a person can be a brahmacharya, may join as brahmacharya, immediately he may migrate to sannyasa ashram also. He may mature very quickly.
Okay.
Right? Or a person become grahastha, but very quickly he may become, mentally he can become sannyasi also.
Right.
So it is by and large for most of the people it is associated with the stages of life.
Right.
But in reality it is associated with the, what you call as, it is associated with mental evolution of a person.
Conscious
evolution of a person, right?
Yeah.
So whether it's vanaprastha or sannyasa, okay, vanaprastha or sannyasa, it's also ashram. Retired life is stress free.
Mm.
Now, is our retired life stress free? So what happens if we worry too much about what to do with my children, what will do my grandson, okay?
Right.
So retired life should be more focused on meditation on God.
Mm.
Then it will be stress-free. That's why you have to be vanaprastha. You have to be out of social commitments.
Mm.
Okay? So the children have to take care of themselves. Now they have grown to a certain level. They have to take care of themselves. You should not spend too much of time worrying about the
right.
issues.
But Rahulji, I see a lot of elderly people, they are not able to give up the attachment.
No, this is where I am saying that the ideal, this is the, our ancestors put a very, very right path for our whole life to be peaceful.
Okay.
So most of the people today don't even know the right path. So they are lost in the various activities.
Mm-hmm.
So this is what life is.
Okay.
Okay.
Right.
So also I want to tell you one article which was published in Times International. Back in 2001 or 2002, I don't remember.
Times International, okay.
Yeah, you may be able to find that article. So that article was just as we entered into 21st century.
Okay.
The article said the 20th century, 20th century has the maximum number of psychiatric patients all over the world. No, 20th century, the last century.
Oh, the last century, okay.
Right? So, the number of psychiatric patients all over the world has increased compared to earlier centuries.
Okay.
Okay? It is very alarming.
Mm-hmm.
Do you know that depression is the largest epidemic in the world? Or largest disease in the world?
Right.
Not cancer, not diabetes. Depression is growing into a larger epidemic than the rest of the other things.
Okay.
Okay. That means mental disturbance, which is loss of, there's no peace.
Hmm.
Right. So recently, I think Deepika Padukone or somebody who actress, I think one of the famous actors, I think remember it's Deepika Padukone, no? She came out how we overcame depression.
Oh.
Right. Oh, I think it's Deepika Padukone. You can check out that.
Okay. I don't know, but I'll check definitely.
Yeah. So, right now, the Times International analyzed why the world has so many people, depressed people, last century.
Okay.
So, the reason they found out is couple of things.
Okay.
One is that, before industrialization, people used to live in smaller communities and house used to be, more people will be there. Alright? So, then what will happen, when more people are there, you don't have any secrets to hide. Secrets. So you bump into somebody, they'll see any small change in your face, they'll see.
Right.
So they'll ask, why, okay, what happened to you?
Right.
So in the process, what will happen? You don't have any pent up built up pressure, psychological pressure. Right?
Right.
So, okay, so that was the, because you are living in a community or living in a joint family,
right,
you didn't have any secrets. Nobody can keep a secret. If you are, some 10 people are living in a house, living in a room,
right,
where is secrecy for anybody?
That's right.
Right? So, less secrets, less stress in the life. Less privacy. Okay?
Right.
So, gradually what happened? The joint families and communities broke up. It became smaller and smaller families.
Mm-hmm.
So now, your contact with other people is less.
Correct.
Right? So because of that, your human contact is less.
What quantity is this?
Human.
Human quantity.
Human contact.
Human contact, yes.
Is becoming less.
Right.
When human contact is less, your psychological build-up keeps on increasing.
Okay.
Psychological, whatever, there's nothing, no outlet.
Right.
So then you start watching more TV and spend more time on the mobile.
Mm.
Even if there are two people in the house, they don't talk to each other. They'll communicate through WhatsApp.
Right.
So now what's happening? Your social, you're living a virtual reality, not the real human being meeting is not there.
Mm.
Okay?
Mm.
So, even neighbors, you...
Yeah.
Huh?
Don't even know who the neighbors are.
You don't even know. So, in the process, what has happened? You have become isolated individuals.
Mm.
And in addition, most of the time, you travel in a car where you don't come in contact with people, right? Some people travel in bus and train when they are not very rich. As they become more rich, they travel in car. Their contact, social contact is going down day by day.
Right.
So now, this in this situation, the psychological stress keeps building. Right?
Right.
You understand?
Right.
So, earlier... Yeah.
I was just telling her the same thing, that if you just, you know, be in your room with the door locked and just keep on spending.
No, this is a very classic. I mean, this is actually, I've heard from my psychiatrist friends, they are getting so many patients only for treatment of WhatsApp addiction, Facebook addiction, and it's very severe.
Right. This YouTube and on the internet also is very...
Right. So now what will happen is, if you look at all these TV serials or WhatsApp or Facebook and all,
mm-hmm,
they are all giving very hyper news. They don't give normal news.
Right.
See, what draws the attention is some negative thing that draws the attention.
Negative thinking?
No. What I'm saying is, news is where there's negative news. That draws the attention.
Right.
So what happens is, constantly you are exposed to negative news, constantly you are exposed to gossip.
Correct.
So you are actually building, you are living in a virtual reality, and what happens to you is a psychological stress.
Correct.
Right?
Hyper reality.
Okay? So this is what they analyzed as the cause, the technology and breakdown of the family system. From joint family to nuclear family also is breaking down because of the technology.
Mm.
Right? And then, in earlier days, in a small village, even if when you go out, surprisingly you meet a bump into a friend.
Mm.
Okay, the friend will suddenly see, hey, what happened to you? There is a surprise element.
Mm.
Okay, now the surprise element is gone. If you want to meet a friend, you have to fix up an appointment. Right? And when you fix up an appointment, you are not natural.
Right.
You put up a face.
Oh my God, yes.
You don't show your emotions.
Right.
Okay, you are dressed to the occasion.
Right.
So there is no outlet for psychological outpouring.
Correct.
So this has caused a tremendous amount of explosion in psychiatric problems worldwide in the last century.
Mm.
and it is increasing like anything. Yes, masks and also they are isolated now. We are no longer a community beings. We are a virtual community, virtual reality beings.
Correct.
So you can find out the Times International article of 2001 and 2002, I don't remember the year, but it will be within 2000 to 2005 somewhere.
Okay. This was on the psychiatric patient maximum.
Oh, sorry?
This was on the psychiatric patient maximum in 20th century.
Oh yeah, yeah. Why psychiatric explosion is happening? Number of psychiatric patients are exploding all over the world.
Okay.
So the solution is, if you have more people to people contact, more your community life.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And less of privacy.
And?
Less of privacy. You live together.
Right.
So, and less of technology. Less use of technology. Technology is when you need it, rather than being addicted to that.
Sorry, I did not get you.
No. Technology like mobile phone, internet, TV and all, you should not be addicted. You should be use it when needed.
Yes, correct.
So with this, your stress will come down.
Just one thing regarding privacy. This is such a important point to people. They say, oh, I also need my privacy.
No, we need a privacy, no doubt about it, okay? But the privacy we misuse. See, the privacy should be spent, okay? If I get a private time, what I do, I spend in meditation. Meditation means I observe myself, okay? I start becoming more and more peaceful in the privacy. But when people say, I want privacy, they'll go to privacy and keep watching TV or keep watching mobile phone. They get addicted to technology.
Or smoke or drink.
So privacy is also useful. But if you are spending it in right way, meditation, silence and peace, it's very useful.
Right.
Otherwise, if you spend in some addiction, what is the use? Yes.
Okay. So, right. So, technology can be one aspect that can be related to this article and how it is creating a divide, isn't it?
Yeah, it is making you more and more individual, one thing.
Right.
Isolating from the society and family. Second thing is you are living in a virtual world. Okay? You can see how fake news propagates faster. How people get agitated by something happens, very quickly it will spread like fire.
Right.
See, if you look at the news, right?
Yes.
The scientists do some achievements. So, tomorrow scientists will land on Chandrayaan, moon.
Yeah.
So, in the whole of newspaper, if you see, it will be two, three column article. But 90% of the articles in the newspaper or WhatsApp or Facebook will be more of some crime, somebody cheated, some...
Right.
So the negative news is what is full, the news media is full of negative news. The positive news doesn't make a noise.
Right.
So when you start living in that virtual reality, mind definitely gets agitated, no? Any questions?
No, but I have never heard this definition of ashram, Prabhuji. Really, I was so surprised to hear this.
Yeah, today the tendency is, I want to get peace, I'll go to some ashram.
Yeah.
Okay, where some Swamiji is there, some put up an ashram, I'll go there.
This thing only came in my mind. Just tell me, Prabhuji.
Yeah. Right? People say, okay, I want to go to some ashram and spend some couple of days and come back. I don't have peace.
Right.
But peace is where you have to find. peace you have to find where you are. Why you are not finding the peace is because you are not focusing on the right thing. Right? In grihastha ashram, you have to focus intensely on dharma, both husband and wife. In brahmacharya ashram, you have to focus on reality. In vanaprastha ashram, you have to focus on God. In sannyasa ashram, you have to focus on self-realization.
Right.
Then you'll find peace.
Right. So actually, Prabhuji, I was in Rishikesh.
Hmm.
I came one week ago.
Mm-hmm.
I was in Rishikesh for a good 17-18 days.
Mm-hmm.
And I stayed there by myself, but went to meet certain person. He teaches Ayurveda, yoga.
Mm-hmm.
Our ancient scriptures as well.
Mm-hmm.
So there, and what you are saying now, like my hesitation for a Grihastha Ashram is already I feel it's gone now.
Yeah.
Really, and because now I got to know the right reason why a family happens.
Yes.
Because earlier, looking at the picture, what the society gives as an idea. I would think as a child, why to go to one family, man, like really?
No. See, the Grihastha Ashram is a very important stage of life.
Right.
Okay, where you have some desires, no doubt about it, because biological, physical, right. Mental desires are there. You have to fulfill. Okay, there is no need to suppress them.
Yeah, I'm saying it's getting what the society, how it projected. By their example, that families are not happy.
No, that's because they don't understand the value of our culture, right? How?
Right. So that is what, seeing that, I felt like, what is the use?
Correct.
But now I know, when you said that Artha and Kama needs to be associated with Dharma, it was like so much of...
Yeah. Yeah, Dharma, both husband and wife, okay, that's important. If husband goes in one way, wife goes in way, another way, it doesn't work.
Right. Mm.
Together they have to commit. That's what is actually our mantras were during marriage ritual.
Mm.
Both husband and wife make a promise to commit themselves to dharma. People don't understand the mantras.
Mm. Wow. This is beautiful, really.
Mm. Yeah. Right.
So why did we used to have large families, five brothers living in the same house?
No, that is because of the system. No, that's a system, right? Where right now people are, each person is one is an engineer, another is a doctor, they'll go in such a profession. Earlier, the whole system was built around agricultural communities, no?
Ah, okay. Agriculture.
Right. So the society was built around agriculture. Yeah, profession, right? So then they live together.
Same work.
Yeah. So now everything is specialization. Somebody go. And job also, you have to keep searching and go from one country to other country also. So it's like a difference. We can't go back to the earlier days.
Right.
But yes, what we have to be careful is about the overuse of technology, over addiction.
Right.
Those things we should be careful. And we should focus on dharma. Focus on Panchayadnas and focus on family life.
Right.
Family life dedicated to Dharma.
Right.
Family life dedicated to producing children who are who will not just become competitive but who have very good values, who will give a very, who will contribute to society and country.
Right.
So these are all values, no? No, what I'm saying, that's what I'm saying. The good relationship, the quarrel happens and fight happens where there's a selfishness.
Oh.
When there's a focus on dharma, there's no quarrel, there's no fight.
Wow, okay.
Right?
Wow.
See, very simple, no? When you are focused on higher, that's why I gave an example of a freedom struggle, right?
Right.
A rich man, poor man, everybody contributed to freedom struggle.
Mm.
But the moment the focus is there, higher purpose. The moment the purpose can become lost, the higher purpose gone. Now it's power for me, money for me. It's selfishness.
Means the whole family, let's say mother and father and the boy and the girl, the daughter and the son, all of them needs to be imbibed with the same values. They must
focus on dharma. Dharma means panchayadna, five yadnas.
Okay.
So, every day it has to be done. It's not once in a while. little bit. Not that you are, it's not that it's not an achievement, right? It is a duty.
It's a process.
Just like you earn your money, just like you have a desire fulfilled, you have to focus on dharma. So where there is no dharma, you might have heard, right? Where there is, you might have heard mythology stories. If there is no dharma, if there is no yadna, asuras will come, demons will come, it says. So this is not demons, physical demons, this is psychological demons. So this is our life now. What to do?
I don't teach all this in school. Unnecessary. I was taking stress for 5-6 years.
They don't teach in your school, so they don't teach in Pravachan also. They don't teach in college and you don't get the clarity in discourses also. Discourses and pravachanas also.
Yeah.
Right? There is a reason for that, okay? See, what happens is that many of these spiritual discourses are monopolized by the monks.
Correct.
Okay, they start talking their way of life. They don't look at the entire life. They don't look at the life where our ancestors have designed.
Right.
Okay, so now this particular discussion, I'm going to post it in the group, okay?
Sure, okay, Prabhuji.
Yeah, I'm recorded, and I don't think anything personal is there. I can post it, right?
Please post it, Prabhuji, definitely. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. It is. For me personally, I'm telling. After the age of 23, 24, when these things really start to come in. As a growing man, you started thinking, okay, maybe 3-4 years down the line, you might be thinking of marriage and all. So, I'm almost like, since 4 years now, I was thinking and I was really jumbled up. Concept of family, why it should be there, why not marriage, really everything got clear now.
Okay, very good.
Unnecessary, it was causing so much stress.
Yeah. See, the causing so much stress because we see broken families, broken relationships all around.
Yes, that is exactly that's what I'm telling. That because this is what society is.
Yeah, and society is what is like that. And then on the other side, we are seeing the spiritual discourse are given by monks, and they say way of monk is the best way. So, what is the right way? The right way is what the way our ancestors have told, ashramas. The four ashramas, brahmacharya, grahastha, vanaprastha, and sannyasa ashrama. As per the ashram definition, if you live properly, life will be very blissful.
Right. Wow, Prabhuji. Thank you so much, really. I'm so thankful and grateful to you. Really, Prabhuji. Really, challenge first to you. Touch your feet.
Okay.
Thank you so much, Prabhuji.
Okay, bye.
I'll try to do this article in the best way.
Okay, very good. You translate and send it to me in English version. Okay.
Sure. Yes.
Pranam.